This is Kibera's slum in Nairobi, Kenya's capital city. Most people don't have access to running water, sanitation, or health facilities. And life expectancy is just 46 years old. It's estimated that a third of the city's population lives here. That's a million or so people. HIV infection is very high. As many as a quarter of Kibera's population is living with the disease. Major Rebecca Nzuki remembers when she first heard about the disease.
One man said, "Captain, we have a new disease here and we don't know it. We are worried about it." And that time, people did not know about HIV and AIDS. I had pain in my heart because I could see people dying. Nobody was talking.
As the disease took hold, the Salvation Army began to help people who were affected. The number of orphans began to grow, and Major Rebecca started supporting children too. The Salvation Army now runs a daily program of activities for orphaned children. As well as offering basic education and a friendly, welcoming environment, the children are given a wholesome midday meal.
Some have no food, some sleep without food, even water, because even water they buy. And they stay with the pain that their parents die. When they come together, those pains go out as they play together.
It's estimated that there are 100,000 orphans living in Kibera. And Kenya faces further challenges. Having seen a drop in infection rates over the last few years, the number of new infections has started to go up again. Stigma and discrimination against people with HIV is widespread and is actually helping to spread the disease. Breaking the stigma is part of the Salvation Army's mission. These days, Major Rebecca coordinates the Salvation Army's HIV/AIDS response throughout Kenya. Today, she's with a local facilitation team visiting a support group at the Salvation Army Corps here in the town of Makindu. Most of them belong to a church, and some are Salvationists. All the members of the group here are HIV positive. The group gives people a chance to share their experiences and talk freely about their illness. They have found that by being open about their status, they can break down the stigma around HIV.
The groups are very important because they share their challenges in life. Some, when they find they have HIV virus, they feel like killing themselves. So as they come together, they help each other to have hope in their life and to continue living, to take care of their children.
Today the group's rehearsing a drama, which they'll use with community groups and in schools to help people understand the disease and get them to talk about it. Pauline Nduku has been part of the group for 2 years.
You know, the stigma of HIV can kill a person. Because if you don't want people to know your status, you won't get medication, or people will know. Before I came here, life was very hard. I felt like I was going to die. I was really lonely and isolated. I had no one to talk to. But coming here, sharing with the group, life has become so much better.
Visiting is a central part of what the group does. Some of the people they visit are group members who are too ill to attend. Margaret Musumbi is a trained community counsellor from neighbouring Kithituni.
People keep dying. HIV/AIDS is killing us. We are left by our friends. They die. They leave behind their children or their wives or their widows. And those times are really difficult times for us.
Salome Masisa is 46 years old. She got diagnosed after her husband died from AIDS 5 years ago. She was left with her 6 children. The youngest, Esther, is just 7 years old and is also HIV positive.
Some of the people living with HIV/AIDS have been very ill and they're not able to do anything. They're just at their deathbed waiting to die, many of them. But after this home-based care and taking the drugs, they become strong again and eat well. We know they can boost their immunity. They have been able to come out strong and live.
When I see teams going out, I feel happy. I give God the glory. It is our people, our children, our patients. Yeah, so I feel happy.
Amen.
We are here to give hope to these people. People will share stories of how they have been through very hard times, but they have seen some light at the end of the tunnel.
The Salvation Army cares for people with HIV and AIDS throughout the world, treating people in hospitals and clinics and supporting them in their own communities. It's working to reduce the spread of HIV and to break down the stigma of the disease. Through its home-based care teams, the Salvation Army is helping to make life better for people living with HIV and AIDS.
Our message to people living with HIV/AIDS is that this is not the end of the road. There's hope. They, as people, can live positively.
Hallelujah.
She's growing strong now.